Joining me now to discuss the president's first foreign trip, the Saudi arms deal, and a White House that is right now besieged in an obvious effort by the left and the deep state to frankly overthrow the government. Retired four-star general, Fox News military analyst, General Jack Keane. General, great to have you with us. Before we turn to even the trip, the fact that this president right now has a national security advisor counseling him to do the opposite of what he was elected to do, that is to name the enemy and destroy the enemy, the Islamic State. He has a coterie around him of people he doesn't know who to trust, who to listen to, and he is being besieged by the establishment, whether it be the national left-wing media, whether it be the deep state, whether it be the establishment as represented by the elites of both political parties. What do you make of it?
Well, first of all, McMaster's and others in the government, the fact that there's disagreement over policy, I don't think that's unhealthy. I think that's largely a good thing. He's got a very mature, sophisticated national security and foreign policy team, and I think by and large, what they have done in these first 120 days and what we're going to talk about next is actually pretty good. What is so troubling and disturbing is that inside and outside the White House, there appears to be a conspiracy to delegitimize this president and to bring him down. I've never seen anything quite like it in my adult life.
And to, if I may, diagram what you just said. You're talking about forces within the White House contending with each other for the power that has been constitutionally granted the President of the United States, Donald Trump. And without the establishment, the deep state, contending with all of the forces, whomever they may be within the White House, but certainly the president, for the power that he is again bestowed by the force of our constitutional political system.
Yeah, I'm not willing to go as far as to say it's in the White House, because I don't think that's been proven. I know from talking to people who I have confidence in.
Where do the leaks
come from? Work in the White House. They believe the leak about the discussion with Foreign Minister Lavrov and the Russian ambassador came from the NSA. And they believe also there were some initial leaks that came from people who worked for the NSC, National Security Council, for our viewers to understand, and they were largely holdovers. So I do think resident in our intelligence services are people who are opposed to the president, and hopefully the leaders of those intelligence services can get these people under control.
What is this president to do? And what are the American people to do? Because we cannot trust the national left-wing media. We cannot trust the establishments of either political party. We cannot trust the deep state in this country that is trying to subvert a presidency, for crying out loud.
Well, I think he should do what he's doing right now, and that is do the nation's business. He's going, he's on his first trip. It is a largely extraordinary trip for a first overseas trip by a president. You know, two regions of the world, four countries, 9 days. That's unprecedented. But more important than that is the message that he's sending. He is telling those two regions and those countries and leaders in that region that the United States is back on a world stage exercising global leadership, promoting stability and security. The byproduct is economic prosperity, and we are not just going to deter our adversaries like Iran and Russia and defeat ISIS. We are willing to confront our adversaries, and that is a loud measure. General, he is reassuring those allies.
General, thank you very much. Why does the phrase enemies foreign and domestic occur to me tonight? General, thanks so much. General Jack Keane.